الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين محمد بن عبد الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين، أما بعد. يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يجعلنا من أهل الإسلام وأهل الإيمان، وأن يحيينا عليه ويميتنا عليه ويبعثنا عليه يوم القيامة. أما بعد، أيها الإخوة الكرام والأخوات الكريمات، The month of Muharram started on Wednesday. So today is the third of Muharram. It is the third day of the Islamic calendar year. It is time to reflect about our last year and plan for the coming year. And this month of Muharram, the month that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to fast most of it, and it's enough for us to know that the name of the month is Shahrullahi al-Muharram, the month of Allah al-Muharram. One of the great events that happened in the month of Muharram is the day of Ashura, which is the 10th of Muharram, which is coming in a few days. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, before the Hijrah, we talked last Friday about the Hijrah as one of the significant events that happened in the Islamic history, the migration from Mecca to Medina. And the position of Ali radiallahu anhu, position of Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, position of Khadija radiallahu anha, position of Asma bint Abi Bakr radiallahu anha, and the position of Al-Ansar, Ahlul Medina, and how they supported Islam and established Islam in the Medina. And because of that establishment and effort, Islam spread all over the world. And now we are Muslims as a result of that, generation after generation. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يجزيهم خير الجزاء عنا وعن المسلمين. In the day of Ashura, which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to fast even before Hijrah, as Aisha radiallahu anha narrated. And she reported that as people of Mecca used to follow the Deen Ibrahim alayhi salam, al-Hanafiyya, Deen al-Hanafiyya, al-Hanif, al-Samh. And we know that Waraq ibn Nawfal, who went to follow the book of Musa alayhi salam, al-Tawrah. And then he believed in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He was the uncle, some narrations, the cousin of Khadija radiallahu anha. And he said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, what you have seen in Ghar Hira is anna Musa alladhi nazala ala Musa alayhi salam. Wa innaka lanabiyu akhir al-zaman. ولو أبقاني الله تعالى لأنصرنك نصرا عزيزا. I will support you and your cause. And he died. رحمه الله. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم gave him a glad tidings of Jannah, that he will be among people of Jannah, as he believed in the message of رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to fast because the Jewish community used to fast. And the previous nations used to fast the day of Ashura. And when he came to Medina, he also found that the Jewish community fasting that day. But why? Because at that day, something very significant is a miracle that happened with Musa alayhi salam and his followers, children of Israel, Bani Israel. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وجاوزنا ببني إسرائيل البحر فأتبعهم فرعون وجنوده بغيا وعدوا حتى إذا أدركه الغرق قال آمنت أنه لا إله إلا الذي آمنت به بني إسرائيل وأنا من المسلمين. فيرو he was a great oppressor torturing the believers claiming that he is the lord of the world. قال أنا ربكم الأعلى. And he was torturing Musa عليه السلام and his followers. Musa عليه السلام and Harun عليه السلام they came to Pharaoh and they conveyed the message of Allah. And Allah سبحانه وتعالى said to them to say قولا لينا to invite him to the Tawheed and Iman kindly and softly and gently even though he was Pharaoh the one who claimed that he is the Lord of the world. But Allah asked Musa عليه السلام and Pharaoh and Harun to invite him to the Iman in kind way and gentle way. And this is a very good lesson for us when we call people to Islam and when we interact with the Muslims to talk to them kindly and nicely about our deen. They rejected the message of Allah and they started to torture Bani Israel, the followers of Musa alayhi salam. Until the moment came, the breaking moment, when they left in secret and they went toward the Red Sea. And Fir'aun and his army followed them, intending to kill them and finish them off. Now you just imagine the Red Sea in the front, Musa alayhi salam and his believers, followers with him, and behind they see Pharaoh and his huge army. So they are in between the water, the Yam, and the Jaysh Amram, a great army. Then that is a moment of testing, a moment of Iman and faith. How strong their faith will be, how steadfast they will be. Then they said to Musa alayhi salam, we are the mudrakun. They will catch us soon. We will go. But Musa alayhi salam said, Inna Rabbi ma'ya sayahdi. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with me and He is gonna guide me. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him to strike his stick. Just imagine that. What Musa alayhi salam had? A stick. Only. A stick. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him to use that stick. Allah could create weapon for him. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him, فَضْرِبْ بِعَصَاكَ الْحَجَرِ And هنا في البحر Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him to strike his stick on the sea, on the water. If you think about it logically, this doesn't make sense. But what does make sense is to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Almighty, the most powerful, that will make this stick works and effective. And then the miracle happened, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the sea كالطود العظيم, كالطود العظيم. That Allah opened and made the water stand to two walls. One large wall in one side and one large wall on the other side and a dry road. And safe road in the middle. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made this miracle. So, what we learn from this? We learn not to give up. People get stressed easily nowadays. People get because they have interview or exam or certain tasks. Or some work to do, or even personal tasks to do at home or in the family, they get stressed and they lose the hope. But what we learn is not to give up and not to despair from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أن لا نكون من القانطين وأن نبقى على عهدنا مع الله سبحانه وتعالى ونكون ثابتين. This is one of the lessons in this. Also we learn that it doesn't matter how much you have resources, but what it matters is to use what you have. وأعدوا لهم ما استطعتم من قوة. Allah سبحانه وتعالى said, you prepare yourself and maximize your abilities, your skills. Do training. Be strong intellectually, in knowledge, physically, practically, emotionally, mentally. And be ready with whatever you can. So not to borrow with haram, not to humiliate yourself to others, not to compromise your deen, but indeed, you stay fast with the principles of Islam and try all the halal means to strengthen your position and stand for your rights. Brothers and maybe sisters upstairs, can you please move forward and fill all the gaps in between? There are many people waiting outside. And indeed, I would like to welcome all the refugees who came to Aberdeen recently. There are many of them living nearby the masjid in large hotels and accommodations arranged by them. And as you know, the arguments about the refugees, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect them and make it easy for them to integrate in the community. We see many of them, they come and pray in the masjid. Also, I would like to welcome the delegate who came from Indonesia, and the ship of Bima Susi, who came and arrived Aberdeen early in the morning today. And 100 of them now, they are with us in the other room. And you may see them with their uniform. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for them to stay in Aberdeen and to see our masjid and community. And they are part of us indeed and part of our Muslim Ummah and Muslim nation. And we would like to welcome them so they can feel home and feel part of the community. Also, we would like to welcome all the Muslims who are coming to the city of Aberdeen through our port, the port of Aberdeen. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the success, economical success of the city and the community together. Fir'aun, he admitted and he realized that he's dying. وجاوزنا ببني إسرائيل البحر فأتبعهم فرعون وجنوده بغيا وعدوا حتى إذا أدركه الغرق قال آمنت. He believed at that moment, but he believed in a very strange way. He said, آمنت أنه لا إله إلا الذي آمنت به بنو إسرائيل. وأنا من المسلمين. He doesn't want to say, Ya Allah, I believe in you. He said, I believe in the Lord that the children of Israel believed in. See the arrogancy until the last minute. But Allah answered him. And Allah said in the ayah, Surah Yunus, Al-an. Now you are coming to believe, it's too late. This is another lesson we learn. People say, sleep on it, sleep on it, think about it, think about it. So many undecided issues in people's life. And then day after day, week after week, month after month, year after year, they are not achieving their wishes because it's actually wishes. They are not practical goals and strategy. There's no action plan. There is no timetable, no schedule. No calendar issue, just wishes. I would like to memorize the Quran. I would like to learn about Islam. I would like to learn so and so degree. I would like to do so and so. I would like to build my house. These are just wishes. But there's no practical planning for it. And then the time will come when the soul reach the throat or the sun rise from the west, then it's too late for people to repent. We cannot say, I'm going to repent, I'm going to change myself, I'm going to fix myself, I'm going to do it. We have the opportunity, we have life, we have the breathing, we have the opportunity that Allah gave us. We are in this world. Allah said it's too late now. You have disobeyed and corrupted the world and mislead people. Now, we will keep your body, not your soul. Your soul will leave you and you die. But we will keep your body. فَالْيَوْمَ نُنَدِّيكَ بِبَدَنِكَ. Why? لِتَكُونَ لِمَنْ خَلْفَكَ آيَةً. So you will be in the museum. You will be, people will know this is Pharaoh's bodies. People will learn from you. Whose people? The believers will learn. The disbelievers will learn. Other Pharaohs who are coming after you also will learn. If they learn. وَإِنَّ كَثِيرًا مِنَ النَّاسِ عَنْ آيَاتِنَا لَغَافِلُونَ. Many people are heedless and careless about the miracles of Allah and the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَقَدْ نَجَّيْنَا بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ مِنَ الْعَذَابِ الْمُهِينَ. So Allah saved them indeed in the day of Ashura. فَأَوْحَيْنَا إِلَى مُوسَى نَضْرِبْ بِعَصَاكَ الْبَحْرِ فَانْفَلَقَ فَكَانَ كُلُّ فِرْقٍ كَالطَّوْدِ الْعَظِيمِ. That's why we fast the day of Ashura. فَالْيَوْمَ نُنَجِّيكَ بِبَدَنِكَ. Look at these ayat. These are amazing ayat. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those one who learn from these ayat. So when your wife tells you something, say, don't give up my wife. Keep going. Steadfast. When your husband says something to your sister, just say, don't give up my husband. Carry on. Steadfast. When your children are coming, oh, it's difficult. Don't give up my child. Carry on. Allah will help you. Link them with Allah. When even your parents give up, oh, children, just say to them, parents, don't give up. Carry on. That's what we have to do. Siblings, my brother, my sister, don't give up. Carry on. That's what we learn from these, to carry on. Because Allah support those one who are steadfast, not the coward, not those one who feel weak and tired. Musa alayhi salam mentioned in the Quran 136 times. And his story were mentioned in the Quran 16 times. And he was mentioned directly or indirectly 25 times in other stories, mentioning other prophets. Isa alayhi salam is mentioned in the Quran 23 times, and as the son of Mary 3 times. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi salam, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi salam, mentioned by name 4 times in the Quran. This shows us a significant lesson as well, that we should learn from previous lessons, from previous experiences, from others. We should not try, people say, I'm gonna try and see, I can make mistakes and learn from it. The deen of Allah is not a joke and it's not a game that you try, maybe lose, maybe you win. We have to learn from other people before us who actually experienced already and made mistakes already and repented already and fixed themselves already. Not everyone has to go and look in the hole and put his head in the hole so to see what's inside that hole. Many heads were cut in that hole. Many people came back in that hole are miserable. So we should not try what everyone is trying. That's why I tell people, vaping and electronic cigarettes is haram. Same like normal cigarettes. Even if you look and search about scientific facts, now they are saying that those one who are using them, they are going to have cancer in 10 years. In 10 years, means it is worse than the normal cigarettes and smoking. Even
They are talking about 200 and something poisons, materials, chemically are entering the body when people are vaping. So why we are trying to experience what people experience first? We should learn. We should respect the Islamic values and Sharia rules and the scientific facts as well. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it easy for all of us to fast the day of Ashura and to follow the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. الحمد لله نحمده ونصلي ونسلم على رسوله The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said أفضل الصيام بعد رمضان شهر الله المحرم وأفضل الصلاة بعد الفريضة صلاة الليل. The best fasting after Ramadan is the fasting of the month of Muharram and the best prayers after the faraid, the obligatory prayers is the prayer at night. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said صيام عرفة أحتسب على الله أن يكفر السنة التي قبله والسنة التي بعده وصيام يوم عاشوراء أحتسب على الله أن يكفر السنة التي قبلها رواه مسلم. And حديث ابن عباس رضي الله عنه قال ما رأيت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يتحرى صيام يوم فضله على غيره إلا هذا اليوم يوم عاشوراء وهذا الشهر يعني شهر رمضان وهذا في البخاري. So if the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم encouraged us in these ahadith and the fasting of the day of Ashura will expiate our sins of previous year and grant us forgiveness of all the previous year's sins, then it is a very great opportunity for us. Another narration, قالوا هذا يوم صالح هذا يوم نجى الله بني إسرائيل من عدوهم فصامه موسى عليه السلام قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فأنا أحق بموسى منكم فصامه وأمر بصيامه. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he saw the Jewish community fasting because the miracle that happened with Musa عليه السلام and his followers. He said, also I will fast. And he fasted that day. And he asked the Sahaba, the companions, to fast that day. And he said that we have, Musa عليه السلام has more rights from us than anyone else. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم fasted the day of Ashura. He asked people to fast it. Also, he said, لَنْ أَحْيَانِ اللَّهُ إِلَىٰ قَابِلْ لَأَصَوْمَنَّ التَّاسِعِ أو تَاسُعَى. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم even had the intention to fast the day of 9th, which is one day before. So what that means? That teach us another lesson to have a unique ibadah as Muslim nation, to have our Islamic identity very clear. So because other communities and other faith groups, they are fasting the day of Ashura, we make our ibadah different. So we have the 9th and the 10th. So now we have levels to fast the day of Ashura alone, which is also accepted and sunnah because the Prophet ﷺ fasted it. And to fast 9th and 10th, the Prophet ﷺ intended to fast and asked people to fast. The Prophet ﷺ didn't fast because he died sallallahu alayhi wasallam before the next Ashura came. صلى الله عليه وسلم جزاه الله عنا وعن المسلمين خير الجزاء المقام المحمود الذي وعده سبحانه وتعالى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. And some of the ulama they talk about one day after to guaranteed in case of there is any moon sighting error. So we have these مراتب of the صيام of Ashura. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala أن يجعلنا ممن يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه. أيها الإخوة الكرام, our life is very short. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وقل اعملوا فسيرى الله عملكم ورسوله والمؤمنون وستردون إلى عالم الغيب والشهادة فينبئكم بما كنتم تعملون. وقال الله سبحانه وتعالى في سورة ياسين, إنا نحن نحيي الموتى ونكتب ما قدموا وآثارهم وكل شيء أحصيناه في إمام مبين. And we should really think about this ayat. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking about our return to Him and the reward that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala preparing for us. And سبحان الله. الله سبحانه وتعالى reward people not only for their good deeds but also for the results of their good deeds. If you teach somebody Surah Al-Fatiha and he is reading Al-Fatiha, as long as this person is praying, you are getting reward even after your death. If you spread knowledge, if you spread good advice, good inspiration, good nasiha, good encouragement, if you set good examples for others, so whatever you do, it will be considered for you as ongoing charity. And subhanAllah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you. And if the person does bad things, also the person will be responsible of the consequences. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala an yaghfir lana dhunubana wa yukaffir anna sayyatina wa yatawaffana ala Allah. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim innaka hamidun majid. Allahumma a'inna ala fi'l al-ta'at wa tarkil al-munkarat. Allahumma ahyina muslimin wa tawaffana muslimin wa alhiqna bis-salihin ghayra khazaya wala maftunin برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم وفقنا لما تحبه وترضاه من العمل الصالح. اللهم تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم، وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم، واغفر لنا ولوالدينا ولجميع المسلمين، والحمد لله رب العالمين.